Tips for traveling. It's myorganized.life live. Show number 100.
Woo!
July 9th, 2018. 100!
Yes, we made it.
Wow.
Can you believe it?
Starting way back in February. You know, 100 adds up pretty quickly
it
when
does.
You're doing five a week.
Yes, I know.
It's like 20 weeks.
Yep.
But some weeks we didn't do five. But
right. I actually went through and hand counted.
Nice.
And yeah.
And this is number
100.
Wow.
Did you play
Happy
the little...
Happy birthday to us.
Happy anniversary.
Happy
anniversary. Wait, what would it be?
I don't know. Milestone. Happy milestone.
Sure. Milestone.
Actually, put in the comments. Here's the comment. First of all, you know, since I've been on break.
Yes, and, you've been on vacation.
Okay, I have to say, welcome to myorganized.life live. I'm John Hunt.
I'm Leanne Thompson.
I'm trying to remember what we're supposed to say when we do this
live.
But anyway, it is Monday, July 9th, back after a great week off.
Mm-hmm.
And
you had a nice week off. I was here.
You were here, but
I just wasn't on air.
That's right. But you were here part of the week.
Yeah.
Okay. So back to that comment thing.
Yep.
We give you organizing tips, advice, and we'd like to get your comments. This is our 100th show. I want to know in the comments, and whether you're watching this live on Facebook or the replay either on YouTube or myorganized.life or on Facebook, is this the first time you've ever seen this show?
Oh, okay.
Or have you seen one of the other episodes?
Okay. Sounds
How's
good.
That?
That's
that a good
comment.
Thing for a comment?
Yeah. Comment if this is your first time watching or not.
And I don't know if they have one of those little birthday cake emojis or whatever.
Oh,
that would be kind of
That would be kind of nice.
Yeah, so if you got time to do that.
I should have brought cake or cookies or something for us.
Yeah. Anyway,
anyway.
Hey, you know, today's is tips for travel, which
right.
is great this time of year. A lot of people coming and going, and mm-hmm. this office is like a...
rotating door,
who's out,
revolving
who's in,
door.
Who's out, who's in,
I
who's
know.
Out, you know, and... So,
and you just had a travel trip. I had a travel trip.
Yep.
I have more travel trips coming up.
I do too. Yeah,
so.
It's going to be fun.
Mm-hmm.
So, what this brings up are these tips for traveling. And we did a podcast. Oh, I can't remember what number.
This episode? Is number 137.
137 with our good friend Louise Kurzika. And it's actually tips for traveling by plane or car.
Or car.
And there are tons of great tips in this episode.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to play a little clip here and then we'll come back and discuss it.
Another thing to think about is how can I be comfortable on the airplane?
Okay.
So one thing that we know is a saline nasal spray is really great for a lot of us because when we get to higher altitudes, the membranes in our nose dry out.
Mm.
When we don't have moisture in our nose, that's when germs come in and hold on.
Oh, wow.
The moister the environment is, the more the germs get washed away. So if you use, I mean, literally this again is what I use before I get on the plane, a couple times during
nice.
The plane and when I get off. So I'm in a sense trying to do that. And then that keeps you healthier,
yep.
which is important. Now, one thing that's not terribly healthy on most planes, if you think about the turnaround time, last time you flew, did you see the plane come in and everybody got off? And then, you know what, 10 minutes later, everybody's
right.
getting on. How thorough do you think that staff can be in cleaning that environment?
They don't have much time, do they?
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
So one of the things that I like to travel with is my own blanket. And again, thinking small,
right.
this is great. It's all compact in this zippered pouch. And now I can pull this out.
Nice.
Yeah. And if you think about a family, this could cover a couple of kids. So again, in the car or... There you go, John.
Yeah, there we go.
Little
hey,
for
it's
you,
nice
little
and
for
cozy.
Me. Yeah, we maybe Ooh. We'll just kind of hang out here with
right.
our little pouch and everything. So you're using your own item. And then, so again, having some disinfectant wipes
right.
that you can wipe off that tray table
yeah.
that food has been on. I look at it when I get to a hotel room. I wipe everything that a hand touches.
Right.
Because I know the staff hasn't been able to do
They just
do
can't
that.
Do it. Right.
Yeah, and it isn't that I think I'm not a germaphobe. It's
right.
not that kind of situation. But I like to stay healthy. I don't
right.
like to be sick, so.
Yeah.
If I can minimize contact, that's a great way to do it.
Awesome. All right. What else you got in your little
well,
bag of tricks?
Well, I got
tricks?
A couple more things here
I
that I like
do.
To have. Another thing that I like to pack going on vacation is a collapsible cooler bag.
Oh.
Now, I don't know about you, but a lot of my destinations by airplane are to a beach or to a place that has a pool.
Mm-hmm.
And so this is great for when you're having any kind of cold beverages
yep.
that you maybe want to take down to the beach or the pool,
right.
Along with some healthy snacks. Because with kids, you know they're selling junk at all of the little stands that are available there. But if you're able to get some, you know, yogurt or some cheese sticks or some other good, healthy fruit and keep it in here, then they're more likely to use that as the snack. But it takes up no space at all in your bag then when you're done and you're putting it away. So again, another space saver.
Great.
Now, another fun thing to take with, and you wouldn't necessarily think so, is a collapsible poncho. So this is one of those very lightweight. It's not going to, you know, in a rainstorm, it's not going to give you a ton of protection. But literally, it folds out to be a full adult poncho. Wow. And I like this for a number of reasons, because it does double duty. Another thing that we like to do when we travel is have things that can do more than one thing. So here's the top of the poncho. You can see where the head would go. So if it does rain quick, you've got something to put on. If you're transferring your luggage, you could pop this over it if, again, it starts to sprinkle. Right. If you're touring some areas and you want to sit down and have a picnic lunch and the ground is all messy or wet, you could lay this down.
Nice.
Or on a park bench. Or it could be a picnic table, a table cover. So that
it's almost disposable, although you probably want to get a few uses out of it, right?
They tend to cost a couple of dollars.
Right.
You get them at a travel accessory store. Not terribly expensive. But I've had this one out a couple of different times and actually used it, and you can get it folded up pretty well and pretty close again. But again, it doesn't take much space, and as you say, if it's disposable, if you got your use out of it, then that's great. And you've kept your clothes clean, which then saves on how many things you have to pack, which is important. Now, the final one I want to show you is an in-case-of kit. So this really is good, not just for traveling by air, but also by car. Mm-hmm. And this should be a kit you have ready to go all the time. So I've got a first aid kit established in here, just one I purchased and put in there. So anything that happens, I've got that covered. And then on the back side, I've got some other in-cases, some medications, over-the-counter medications or make you feel better items that you might need, a sewing kit. Because if you don't have the sewing kit, for sure you're going to need it. Mm-hmm. But if you have it with, it's Murphy's Law. You'll probably like. Or here's some, you know, muscle if you from walking and such, some muscle relaxing kind of heating pads. So look at what you need: allergy medication, you know, anything that you need to have in case of.
Right.
Then pop it in there and keep that in the car all the time when you're traveling by car, and then put it in your bag, a carry-on for when you're going on the plane, and you're all set.
Okay.
All right.
Louise Kurzika, you know, she's the boss.
She knows everything about everything.
She does.
Yep.
I love the whole thing about the in case of kit.
The in case of kit, yes.
Know, and
later in the episode, she talks about, you know, making the ride more comfortable, maybe some kits for kids. Which
I mean, when you're traveling with kids, smaller kids, you can appreciate
this. Especially when the Wi-Fi goes out when you're way up north.
Oh, and my gosh.
The iPad is no longer in
no
use.
No Wi-Fi.
And
you're
there's
in big trouble.
A meltdown city.
I know.
It's bad, isn't it?
It used to be the DVD player in the thing. Now it's like Wi-Fi and, you know, iPad. If iPad no work,
oh gosh,
kid no happy.
Right.
Right? So
I don't want that show. I want YouTube.
Yeah, YouTube. Oh,
gosh.
Your daughter, she's about three now, right?
She just had a birthday. Both my daughters just had a birthday.
Yeah, so she's going to probably want her own YouTube channel pretty soon, right?
Probably.
Oh, my goodness.
I'm sure. She's going to be one of those kids that's opening the toys.
Well, we should say shout out to Natalie and Elin because of their birthdays.
Yes,
you know, even though it was
last
week.
Happy birthday, girls.
Right.
Right. Yep.
But, you know, because we like to shout. That's another thing we do on this show is shout out
birthdays. Birthday shout outs.
I was telling my daughters, that I did a shout on their birthdays in our previous. Oh, really? What'd you say? I used to watch the show.
Watch
to
the
see,
show. Figure
know?
It out.
If you want to know what we're saying, you got to watch the show.
That's right.
You never know what's going to be happening on
That's
the show.
That's right. Yep.
All right. Well, gosh, we're back to a full week, right?
Yes, full week.
Tomorrow we'll have some great stuff.
Yep. Oh, well, I have the calendar all made, and I don't have it in front of us, so I don't know what's coming up.
But we do know on Wednesday, we had no podcast last week, so this Wednesday we have a new podcast.
New podcast.
And I believe
it's
with a brand new person who's never been on it before.
Okay.
So we'll give you more teasers maybe about that tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
And
we'll have the calendar with us.
Then Thursday we'll have some solutions. Friday we'll do the blogger roundup. And hopefully some of the bloggers are not on vacation.
Right.
Because we'd like to know. If you have a good blog that you like to follow that has to do with organizing, put it in the comments too, because we're always looking for new people to discover, right?
By the way, I heard back from Julie Bestry.
Yeah?
She got my thank you note.
She did.
Thanking her for the thank you.
Yeah, well, I was wondering if you actually remembered to do
it. I remembered. I sent it that day.
You had left early that day, and I was like, oh, gosh, I wonder if she did the thank you note.
I did.
Good for you.
I actually texted her yesterday because she likes to see pictures of my kids, so I sent her a picture of Elin on her birthday, and
nice.
She wrote back, and thank you for the thank you note.
Oh, great. Now you'll have to thank her for the endless cycle.
Yeah.
Well, that's it for today's show. Monday, July 9th, we're back into it. It's exciting. It's summertime. I love it. It's my favorite season of the year.
Yep.
And we'll be back tomorrow, 2 p.m. Central, 3 Eastern, noon Pacific, right here on MyOrganized.life Live.